nations are going to drop in the bucket before
Let's
you.
Let's go.
Who is like you to hang the earth on nothing?
This is a hard turn.
You tell the
right here?
It's a very difficult turn here. Like yeah.
Because I don't want to slide into the car. I'm about to.
You are mighty. You are glorious.
That's it.
You are the everlasting God, the infinite God, the transcendent God.
Yeah.
Through all fire. Four living creatures surrounding you, day and
so much glory in this song.
Yeah, it's
just the perfect way. Man, what a way to start today, you know? It's the glory to your life.
Thank you.
Thank you, my brother.
See you, Scully over now.
Tomorrow in Mexico. Oh, yeah. You want to say something to the viewers?
Yeah, have a blessed Sunday. God bless you all, guys. Ade bra.
Come on. God loves you.
Amen. God loves you.
See you, brother.
See you, man.
Glory.
You are the one who saves. Yeah. Lifted high, the name we shout from the name. Thank you.
That's it. Hello, everyone. I just need to charge my car. Need to charge my batteries. So, yeah, I think it's charging now. Come on. How's everyone going on Facebooks? Hello to all my fans and friends. I've been having a sleeping night shift at work, so I'm on my way home, but I need to charge the car because I'm picking up Grace and the kids to go to church at 12 at Catch the Fire. So that's pretty cool. It's a busy life. So now, right now I have to charge my electric car. Just like you need to do with your spiritual battery, you know, you need to charge it by worshiping and praying and reading the Bible. So that's my life. That's the best life you can have, to live in the glory. So probably, I don't think I've told my testimony before on Facebook, and maybe I should tell you guys. I sort of had a rough upbringing. So when I grew up, I was sort of hard and, you know, got into fights all the time and stuff like that. You know, I got kicked out of school everywhere and all the shopping malls around, and was just filled with hate because of the things I had experienced when I was young. But one day when I got older, my cousin was gonna start this Bible school in Oslo, Philadelphia, Oslo, for those who know that place. And he asked me if I knew about a place that he could stay. And at that time, you know, I was into partying, you know, I went to Ayia Napa, being drunk 24/7. You know, I sort of always believed in God, but I didn't have a relationship with him, you know. But, yeah, so I said to him that, hey, dude, you can move into my place. So he did, and, you know, one day he was going to church, and he asked me if I wanted to come. And I was like, yeah, okay, I'll come for your sake, you know, to be nice, you know. And this was in Philadelphia, Oslo, or Philadelphia Kirken, as they have changed their name now, too. So when I came there, you know, I was sitting on probably fourth row or something. They had this information thing during the service. You know, they were like, so on Wednesday this and that is happening, and so while I was sitting there, suddenly just something hit me. It was like, it felt like a bucket of hot water that was thrown over me, but with love. It was just the most amazing thing I ever experienced, and I just started to cry. And I cried and I cried and I cried, and all the hate and all the anger just disappeared. And I just knew this was God, you know, that, you know, it was him doing this. And I just was like, wow, I didn't know it was like this, you know. God is so amazing. So, yeah, like I said, you know, all the hate, all the anger just disappeared, and I just wanted to live for Jesus from that moment on. And the first thing God told me actually at that service was that, Stein, remember that you become like the people you hang out with. So find Christians that are on fire, and that just don't say that they're on fire, but live it. That was the first thing God told me, actually. The second thing was that, hey, you should start a Bible school. So after, so I actually went up to the principal at the service, and I asked him if I could start. And at the same time, there was like 150 people that was gonna get fired or had to quit at the job that I was working at. So I knew I was one of them. So I went to my boss at work and said, hey, I'm gonna quit, and I'm gonna start this Bible school. So after a week, after I got saved, I did Bible school in Philadelphia, Oslo. And the craziest thing, that was the craziest thing, you know, because I was so scared going to the Bible school and worship and stuff, because I didn't know how to do it. So when they had worship and you know, I was just sitting there next to my cousin, you know, I didn't dare to stand up and lift my hands and or do anything, get it, you know, get into it, because it was all so new, even though I had experienced it before, you know, with my family and stuff when I was younger, when I went to church. But it was also new to me. But, you know, I just took it step by step. And one day I just chose to stand up during worship. And, you know, the other day, you know, I closed my eyes and lifted my hands. And I just took it step by step. And a year later, I was, you know, sharing my testimony with like 1,000 kids at this Christian conference thing. And, you know, after that, I've been, you know, praying for people that are sick and seeing people being healed. And it's the most amazing life you can ever have, you know, to be in a relationship with the one who actually created you. You know, he loves you so much, and he just changed my life. So there's no way back for me. And the only way to live it is to just live in the fire, you know. That's the only way. Because if you don't do that, you will get have this religious life, you know, it will get super boring. So it's a life that you have to live out, you know. If you see someone sick, you know, just go and pray for them. And, you know, God will work through you. Now my wife is trying to call me. That's really weird because I'm live. She knows I'm live on Facebook. But yeah, you know, I started to see people getting healed when I prayed for them, and I just took it step by step. And I experienced things like all the time. Like yesterday, I got to pray for this woman that had trouble sleeping for like 20 years. I was sitting in a cafe in Oslo. She just walked past and she looked at me, and I looked at her and I smiled and I said, how are you? And that's how it all started. Then she just suddenly opened her heart and, you know, told me about all her problems and stuff. And I just asked her, you know, can I pray for you? She was like, yeah, yes, please. She was so open. So I just started to pray, and she was like, wow, I've just felt this thing lifted from my head and from me. You know, I just feel so much lighter in my head. And she got really touched and, you know, teary by the presence of God. But she was so thankful when I left, and she gave me a hug, and yeah, so good. And that's what the Christian life is about, you know, to love people. This guy said one time, you know, that preach the gospel, but if necessarily use words. You know, which means that it's about, you know, loving people. It's not about all the words you have to say, but it's about being love, you know? Being like Jesus is, you know? He is love. He loves everyone. And that's our job as human beings, to just love each other. So, yeah. So if you haven't experienced or you know, if you haven't experienced God's love before, dude, come on. What are you scared of? He loves you. You don't have to become anything, you know, but you need to open up your heart for God and let Him come into your life. He will change you, you know. He will teach you how to love. He will show you what love is all about, you know, because he created you, and this is your purpose, you know, of this life, to get to know him and love everyone around you. So yeah, so that's sort of my story. I'm not someone special, I'm just a normal guy, you know. Back in the days, I used to beat people up and get into trouble all the time, you know. Broke into places and stole things and, you know, just being an idiot. But I opened my heart for God and he just changed me. And now he actually uses me to let people see him. But that's pretty amazing, you know. Just like shitty little Stein from Lønnskog. So, yeah. So give it up. Give it to Jesus. Come on. Everyone thinks I'm crazy. That, you know, some people think I'm crazy because I'm so in love with Jesus and what he has done with me, done for me. But it's just the only way for me to live. So it's the best life you can ever have. So. So right now I'm charging my car on my way home from work. I had a sleeping night shift. So I'm on my way to Jessheim. It's the Bondi Beach of Norway. Ullensaker. So I have to charge my car because I'm picking up my kids and wife to go to church. So it starts at 12 and now it's 10. So we don't have much time really, because it takes like 40 minutes or something to drive into Oslo. So, yeah. If you have any questions or anything, just pop them up on the chat. I'll answer them. All my friends, fans, and viewers on Facebook. Glory, glory. So, so it's been snowing heaps. It's pretty crazy, actually. And it's been melting, so it's sort of like a thin, it's like a layer with ice underneath the snow. So it's super slippery. So yesterday when I went out, I just fell straight on my ass because it was so cold. I mean, it was so slippery because of the ice. So, come on. So I do miss Australia on days like this, that's for sure. Yeah, we'll see if we ever move back or what's gonna happen. So I can show you guys right here. This is where I'm at, charging my electric car. Because in Norway everything is electric, not everything, but so I think I'm almost done charging. I have to keep driving home to pick up the kids and Grace to go to church it up. Glory. Okay. Yes, I am here. We come. Probably have to start the car. pretty cool. Okay, guys, I'm done with showing my face. Love you. Peace. Glory, 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 glory.
Around your throne, the elders around your throne. join the song of heaven, we say, God, you are holy. God, you are beautiful. Lamb of God, you are worthy. Take our stand on the sea of glass, mingle with fire. We lift our gaze to you, O God. From whence comes our help? Our help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. We bless you.